How do you make a fin stronger without adding a lot of weight? That's what I'm going to cover in this video.
Welcome to Advanced Construction Videos, where we show you how to tackle rocketry, building techniques, and more. On our website, we sell kits, motors, building supplies, and electronics. So come and learn, shop, build, and fly when you visit us at ApogeeRockets.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Van Milligan from Apogee Components. Today I'm going to show you a technique to put a skin on a balsa wood fin to make it a lot stronger. Now, I've done a similar video to this in the past, and it was like episode number 16, and we're now on episode number 381 or 82. But this is going to be a little bit different technique because I've evolved over the years and I've discovered new ways of doing things. So some of it's going to be similar, but some of it's going to be new. The reason to paper a fin is because balsa wood, while it's really light, it can snap pretty easy. So if we put a paper skin on it, the paper takes up a lot of the load and makes the fin a lot stronger so that it, you know, it can bounce on the ground and take a lot of abuse without cracking. So the technique is we're going to use regular, you know, just copy paper. And our first step is just to trace a pattern, and we're going to cut this pattern out. So I'm just lining up the edge with the edge of the paper because I know that that's a straight edge. And then I'll just trace around it with a pencil. And then we'll just cut that out. So I know this edge right here is straight, so I'll start with that one first. And then I'll just carefully just cut around the perimeter. And it doesn't have to be perfect. Mine never are. And if you watch these videos, you see that I make a lot of mistakes, but that's okay. You know, being able to correct them is what's important. So I've gone ahead and done several sheets already. Our next step is we're going to transfer this onto the paper, and we need it to stick. So what I'm going to use is some spray adhesive. So this is kind of like rubber cement in an adhesive form. And what I'm going to do, well, first what I need to do is to lightly sand the surface just to make sure everything's flat and smooth. It doesn't take much. Okay, so now my surface is nice and flat. I'm going to take my pattern, and I'm going to take a piece of cardboard, and I'm just going to spray that lightly. This is just to get this to stick, and then I'll just spray it again. And you really want to do this outdoors because you don't want to be breathing this stuff. And so that was really light coats, and I had it about 12 inches away when I sprayed. And it's nice and tacky right now, but it's not like super tacky. This is not going to give us the strength. What all this is going to do is allow us to put it onto the fin and keep the paper in place so that the paper doesn't move around on us. And it will easily come up, but that's okay. What we want is just to have it stay in place. Then we're going to take water thin super glue. And you're going to need some paper towels handy and plastic bags because you don't want to touch the super glue with your hands. If you do, what I recommend is using the Happy Hands. This is a hand cream that you put on your hands, and it's basically a wax, and it prevents the super glue from sticking permanently to your skin. So it will stick, but it will peel off, you know, probably within a half an hour. And I also got a piece of paper here, or plastic, to protect my table. And wear safety goggles when do this. Have your paper towels handy. So our next thing is we're going to paint on the super glue. And we're using the applicator wick as kind of like a paintbrush. And then I'm going to take off any of the puddles. And you can see that the wood grain is starting to show through. And it's also creating those fumes that we all know and love so much. I'm kind of tilting it down so that gravity is kind of taking it down to the edge for me. So just kind of paint it on. Again, just wipe it off. And you want to do it fairly quick because you don't want it to harden on the surface, because then it's going to leave bumps that you got to sand out. Also wipe off the tip to get that off. And if it becomes clogged, just take the tip and throw it in some acetone for a few hours or overnight, and that will dissolve the super glue, and then the tip will be ready to use again. So right now this is a little bit tacky, but you can do the other side. So I gotta make sure I spray the right side here. So you want this little light because you don't want the rubber to create a barrier where the super glue doesn't penetrate through the paper. This is still a little bit tacky, but what I wanted to show you is that at this point I can't lift up the edge and peel it off because the super glue actually went through the paper and attached it to the wood. Okay, and in a few minutes, like this side is pretty much dry right now. This side is still a little tacky. At that point, you can start sanding when it's hardened. You can start sanding and smooth out the surface. So that is way stronger now, and it's nice and smooth, and it seals the surface all at the same time. Now you still have to do your edges. I like to have mine flat because people ask me, why don't you airfoil them, Tim? And the reason is they photograph better, I think. This is just a personal opinion. But you can round off those edges if you want to airfoil them. And you're gonna have to go into the paper, which is fine. You're just sanding away the paper. So when I'm doing it, I'm kind of rounding it off like this. Okay, so that's a beautiful edge right there. And then you can see here, there's some hanging over the edge, and you can sand that off as well. You can see it's kind of like right there. But once the super glue saturates it, it makes it much more rigid and easier to sand off. Okay, so that's a basic flat fin technique. Now this particular fin, I've airfoiled it. So this one does have an airfoil on it. And if you look at the edge, see this one, if you look at it straight down, it's just a rectangle. This one is kind of a teardrop shape where it's rounded on this edge and then it comes to a point back here. And in fact, I sanded it so much that I sanded actually through, it should look like that, but I sanded too thin. It's too thin right there. But with the paper technique, we can actually save this fin. So we're gonna try this same technique on this one. And then, what the paper is gonna do, it's going to create a thickness there, and that will save that fin. So before it was ruined, once we get the paper on, it should be fine. So again, this side. While I'm waiting for that to harden, I'll go ahead and do the other side. The fumes are making my eyes tear up. All right, that looks pretty good. And that edge is now solid. Makes it a lot stiffer, looks nice and straight. That's gonna be beautiful right there. So that's my newer technique on how to paper fins. The key ingredient is right here, the spray adhesive. And it doesn't have to be this particular brand. There's 100 different brands of spray adhesive. I kind of look for a low tack adhesive, not something that's really aggressive, because it leaves more residue everywhere. So once this is sanded down, this will be perfect. If you like this technique, give us a thumbs up or put a comment down below. We love hearing from you, our viewers. My name again is Tim Van Milligan. This is the Apogee Rocketry Workshop. May the winds be light, may the skies be blue, and may all your rockets fly straight and true.